that's a, that's like a goose or something. I think that's a goose. I think, pretty sure that's a goose. Yep, that's a goose. I mean, or a duck. I have no idea what I'm looking at.
This is just like, you know, I do this all the time.
You know, I get in, way too involved.
You know, I probably started on the bus and I saw some poster about bird watching or heard something on the radio about bird. Or just, you know what, I probably just saw a bird, you know, and then I thought, hey, I have a propensity for this. I'm a bird watcher.
I am, got the vest, you know, got the binoculars,
look like Audubon himself. Whereas a normal person would see a bird and they'd say, oh, look at that, a bird. I'll go back to my life now. Not me. It's not like I'm OCD or anything like that. I don't have to lick all the clothes I have before I put them on.
I think I just really enjoy, maybe it's just that I get real hyped up about new activities. And then I realize, oh, this thing that I've become horribly interested in is really boring. I mean, bird watching. This is ridiculous. Standing around, why don't I, let's hunker down and find a good spot to watch spastic rocks. They just hop.
I got a million examples. The train, you know, model trains. I decide I'm gonna get into model trainery. But instead of actually investigating model trains, which gauge, a locomotive I wanted, I decided that I should spend all my time and effort trying to locate the greatest engineer's hat. You know, the striped one with the blue, they got a little bill. Day and night, on the internet, on the phone, calling all over the country, trying to find this hat. My wife, she kind of gets fed up with it, and she says, well, since you're interested so much in model railroad, maybe you should get a model railroad. And I try to cover up. I go, oh, yeah, no. I already just found the right one. So I go to some hobby shop and just grab some piece of shit. So I get home, and I just slap the whole thing together, put it on a piece of plywood in the middle of the garage. It doesn't work. Of course it doesn't work, because I don't know what I'm doing. And so she comes in, and she says, this is just like all the other stuff you get interested in. And I go, no, what are you? She goes, what's that? And she points to this orange traffic cone that I have in the middle of the track. She goes, well, what's that? I go, that's the mountains. That's scenery. See, I care. I'm going to do this forever. I mean, of course she was right. And that stuff just sat there in the garage until I got interested in some other fucking thing like horse photography or something. Or
skydiving lessons.
Rock climbing. It just never ends. The dog breeding. Apparently I was supposed to feed them more. They got really fucking aggressive. Stamp collecting. That's a thrill. You gotta touch them with tweezers.
Guess how many caves I've been in? None. But I have a closet full of spelunking gear if you're interested. Christ, I'm just a fucking idiot.
It's ridiculous. You know what, though? Forget it. You know what? No, I'm not. I'm
sit down, and I am going to wait for the birds to return.
This is something I enjoy. This is my new passion.
Honey, I'm going bird watching again. Again. This is the first in a series of my bird watching experiences. That's what this is.
Okay, I'm going to find out where to find a ruddy turnstone.
I'm not going to start surfing.
Nope.
Collect antique pistols, you know, those dueling pistols in those sweet wooden boxes with the... Nope. Not that, you know, the frequency, the guys on the radio that talk on that, well, they have their own frequency, and they sit down in their basements and they, you know, they, come on, what is it? Ham radio. That sounds cool, though, doesn't it? I think they have, like, you have to have special headphones. Shit.
Birds, I'll not interrupt you anymore. Enjoy your privacy.